Welcome everyone! It's been too long since I've been on there. Too long indeed. Hello everyone, this is Ryan Lifesword, and I am back once again. I'm sorry I've been off for like, well, a year. I've just been pretty nervous. But as you can see, a new world has came out and it's called Polaris, and that's what we're gonna do. And during my absence, we've been doing some Darkmoor runs, and we got the full set of gear, including my Storm. So, let's go check out the new world, shall we? This is gonna be hilarious. Oh, man. Let's go check it out.
There you are. Today is an auspicious day. Most auspicious. It's time we address a matter that is long overdue. Yes, indeed. I remember when you first set out for Unicorn Way. Bright-eyed and brimming over with potential. Oh, seems like just yesterday. Of course, much has happened since then. The troubles with Malastare and Morganth. We've had you traipsing all over the spiral. Yes, you've done all that was expected and more. The faculty is all in agreement. It's time for your official graduation from Ravenwood.
Oh, I'm so excited.
It'll be quite an affair. Don't delay now. Mr. Lincoln awaits you in the Cabinet of Wonders. He will prepare you for the ceremony.
Okay, where am I supposed to go? Oh. My bad. Let's see how we look. Let's check in.
Hello there, young wizard. I hope you're as excited as I am. I can barely keep my reading glasses perched on my bill.
I know, right?
Such a landmark occasion. It's not every day we have a graduation ceremony at Ravenwood. In fact, I can't recall the last time it happened. I've had a cap and gown fitted just for you. Very elegant, I think. Put them on and step into the tapestry to reach the ceremony grounds. Headmaster Ambrose wants this day to be extra special. Many distinguished guests have come to congratulate you. Let's not keep them waiting.
All right. Oh, I'm so excited to do what to do.
The gown is made from rich cashmere, giving it a fuller depth and soft luster sheen. And the cap is quite stately.
I look amazing. Do I look amazing? I look amazing. Oh, shortcut. Here we go.
The grounds of Ravenwood are decorated like never before. Colorful banners are everywhere, and a colorful array of guests as well.
I'm so excited.
It is indeed a most festive occasion, and to think it's all in your honor.
This is just like school graduation, isn't it?
Welcome, wizard. It is my distinct pleasure to call you before Great Bartleby this day. To recognize your remarkable list of accomplishments. You have not been with us at Ravenwood for very long, yet you have had a profound impact on the school. Indeed, across the spiral as a whole. All of the esteemed guests who have gathered here today are familiar with your shrewd mind, your heroic spirit, and noble virtue. None more so than your distinguished teacher, Professor Melinda Wu.
My dear student,
thank you, Melinda Wu.
Many forms of life in your pursuit of knowledge. Some bad, much good, and a handful that are beyond our realm. I have but shown you the door to an infinite number of wonders in the spiral. You are the one who stepped through. Soon you will see it is more varied than we can ever imagine. I cannot wait for you to share your newfound knowledge with us.
Me too.
Wizard, you've been more than an exemplary student. You've been an inspiration. And in the first moment, you've become wonderful friend. And so, without further ado, I hereby pronounce you a graduate of the Ravenwood School of Magic, with honors even.
I think I spoiled the moment. I think I spoiled it. But just ignore it. Huh? Uh-oh. Oh my, what's going on with Bartleby?
Oh dear. Well, that was certainly unexpected. Did you see Bartleby? I've never seen him quite so frightened.
I don't know what happened.
And there goes Professor Wu inside the World Tree. Perhaps you should go and ask if she needs assistance. I hope you can discover the meaning of this. I'll be in my office.
I'll do anything. I'll see what we can do. Let's find out. Wu? Speak to me. Oh yeah. This thing's loading. I'm gonna stop here and... I'm not gonna stop. I'm just gonna wait until it loads, so I'll see you all then. Alright, I'm back. Sorry I forgot to tell you this, but I kind of warned you that there's gonna be some connection losses, but that doesn't really matter. If they happen, they happen. And I just stop recording until... if it happens again. So, let's talk to Melinda Wu and see what's up.
Goodness gracious, what happened? It looks like that chill wind has made Bartleby sick. But how could that be?
That's what I want to know, too.
Bartleby's been standing here strong and healthy ever since... well, ever since the dawn of time. To see him sick, it worries me. I am ashamed to say, I don't even know what ails him. Maybe Bartleby himself knows what's wrong. Would you be a dear and go ask him?
Sure. Oh, I'm supposed to go there. Okay. Okay, I cannot seem to get out. Oh no, it's happening again. Seriously, something's wrong. Okay, let's continue. There's a dinosaur stuck in the way. Okay, I'm sorry. What is going on here? That was close.
Cold. Such a cold wind. Chills one right down to the roots.
Bartleby? Take all the time you need. Actually, don't.
From whence did it come, though? That is the cause for concern. A far, far away feeling. where land meets the sky. Oh, I do not feel well. Tell Ambrose, there is trouble where land meets the sky. Yes, where land meets the sky.
Okay, I'm gonna put on my... Okay, let's put on our gear. Are those right? Okay. Alright. Tomorrow, Ambrose! Ugh! What is going on here? Alright, we're back. Just gotten word that Bartleby has gone to cold, and we're gonna go to Merle Ambrose to see what's the problem. Just have to check the dialogue. Okay, here we go.
Yes, our new graduate. I'm so proud. But you look worried. Is everything alright?
Not really.
Bartleby is sick? Well, nothing like this has ever happened. It's quite disturbing. Chilling, even. That wind must have been very cold.
Yeah.
What did Bartleby say, though? Where land meets the sky. It sounds vaguely familiar. Perhaps something to do with Polaris.
Polaris.
Polaris is one of the worlds that old Cobb mentioned, is it not? Oh, dear. Yes, we need to look into this. We should ask Professor Drake. Cyrus, of course. He spent some time in Polaris, as I recall. Go ask if Bartleby's words make any sense to him.
All right, let's go on to Cyrus Drake. Let's see what he knows. Then we go to Polaris. This is great, isn't it?
Back for more applause. I'm all clapped out, I'm afraid. Or is this something more serious? It's Bartleby, isn't it? Sick. How unexpected. Where land meets the sky. Yes, that is a reference to Polaris. It lies at the very edge of the spiral, the horizon, as it were. But why it would make Bartleby ill, I have no idea. Perhaps there is someone in Polaris who might know. An old witch. Baba Yaga, as she's called. She was a friend once. Baba Yaga's a bit of a recluse, hard to find. But she has a henchman, a former circus strongman, dubiously named Ivan the Great.
Ooh, Ivan the Great.
Take the spiral door to Polaris. It leads to the capital, Walruskburg. Ask around for Ivan the Great. Hopefully he can lead you to Baba Yaga.
Okay, then. Let's go. We're off to Polaris. There was a song I was gonna write, but... Nah, forget the song. Polaris, here we come. Oh. Okay, did not see that one coming. Be right back. Okay, time to step in Polaris.
Stop right there. Before you may proceed, you must hear the official welcome to Walruskburg.
I'm not impressed. Oops, should have said that. Okay, let's hear the welcome.
On behalf of her most grandioseness, Empress Antusquette the First, I welcome you to Walrusberg, crown jewel of Polaris.
Thank you.
Enjoy our glorious city, but abide by the rule of imperial law. No merrymaking, no fishing, no magic, no singing, and no leaving the city.
Really?
A curfew is in effect in some parts of the city from sundown to sunrise. This is a winter season, so the next sunrise is many months away. Also, in accordance with law 3-1604, I must ask, what is your business in our fair city, Ivan? Ivan who? You mean Ivan the Terrible?
What? I thought it was Ivan the Great.
Bah! Ivan is under arrest. That rabid beast nearly destroyed the Inn of the Midnight Sun. Go see for yourself, if you must.
Well, if you say so.
The inn is quiet, and you don't see any signs of a struggle, at least not in here. The innkeeper looks frustrated, however, and he keeps glancing nervously at the door to the back room.
Look, I don't want any more trouble. The inspectors told me to keep my mouth shut, so I'm not saying a word, not while they're here. If you have questions, you have to go back into the feasting hall and talk to Inspector Clouseau.
Ooh, okay. Let's get our deck set up. That's my deck, right? Okay, that's the one. Here we go.
What is this? Some kind of intruder? This is a crime scene intruder. By order of the inspector's brigade, I am putting you underneath arrest.
Whoa, he just pulled us in. 12,500 health. Oh, that's not so bad. Let's see what he's got. Oh, he's got some shift spells. That's new. Oh my gosh, are you... Okay, oh, are you kidding me? Oh. That was a wacky start. Just pulled the plug on us. No need. One Stormblade coming up.
Yeah.
So, since this is my first time in Polaris, they got like a different group amount of spells. Okay. Attacking the next round. What? Oh. Wow. Right when I attack. At least this one doesn't have any resist. Oh, we'll see about that, because I got Pierce. Nice. But he's got low health. We're gonna have to finish this up fast. So, here we go. Oh, are you kidding me? Not that again. Oh, he's good. Oh, but I powered through. Lucky. Alright. Any other glowbug squalls? Nope. Okay. Gonna use a rebirth now. Yay! Sayonara. Ugh. Come on, power through this. Boom shakalaka, you're done. Yeah, get the crit through! Oh, wow. Alright. That fall.
You will regret this, intruder. I never forget a face. Especially when you stick your nose right in the middle of it.
Tell that to the judge. And here we go.
Clouseau may come back and hassle me later, but it was worth it just to see the look on his face. Oh, you're a friend of Ivanson. Oh, you've never met him. Don't listen to the inspectors. Ivan's the best Oski I know. This wasn't his fault. The inspectors are to blame. They were roughing up some innocent penguins and Ivan intervened. Took 10 inspectors to restrain him. Locked him up in the Bastille now, like everyone else who steps out of line. Even packed like sardines. I can't imagine how they fit them all. Listen, you want to help Ivan out? You're no friend to the inspectors, so I'll tell you. Talk to Red Rosa at Lacombe's Press.
Red Rosa? That's some pretty name. And we have to defeat Clouseau again, so here we go. And I just have to get on. Where'd he go? Well, I'll be on my way. I don't want to waste time. Do-do-do-do-do-do! Wait, where am I supposed to go? Oh, here we go.
Yes, I am Red Rosa, but what is it to you? Are you conducting a census for the inspector's brigade?
Nope. Ugh. Talk to me.
Innkeeper Gerbon sent you. I don't know why. You have a friend in the Bastille, but who doesn't? All right, tell you what. There's a place in the harbor, Le Nettoyage. It's where we cleaned fish. Well, until fishing was outlawed. Maybe you come down to Le Nettoyage, and maybe we talk some more. No promises, but maybe. Oh, and watch out for the Inspector's Brigade. With a curfew, no one is supposed to be on the street in the harbor.
Harbor. Oh, we'll see about that. Wow, I really like Polaris. Never been here before, but I really want to give this a test run. Here we go, to the harbor. What? Wait, where are we going? Oh no. No, 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 no! I'm just going backwards! Okay, something's really wrong. Alright, continuing with our journey in Polaris. That must be where we're supposed to go. What the?
There you are. A wizard from Ravenwood, yes? Don't be surprised. We've been watching you ever since you stepped through the world door.
Really?
Attention, my fellow patriots. Our new friend has arrived.
Nice greeting.
If you haven't realized it yet, the Empress has become as mad as a colony of sea monkeys to outlaw fishing. And this curfew, it cannot stand. This is a revolution. We will free everyone from the Bastille and bring down the Walrus regime. First, they must know we've had enough. We will dump their rotten, stinking, imported fish into the harbor. One of the ships on the docks has many crates, but we don't know which ship. If you will go to the Inspector's Brigade headquarters and get the Harbor Master's report, we can find out. Do this, and you will earn our trust.
I kind of liked that speech at the very beginning. That was amazing. Oh man, I'm just like... Ooh, gotta be careful there. Okay, this is a shortcut. Hey, that's nice. Ooh, just gotta be very careful to get past them. Whoa! Whew, I kind of worry a lot. Okay, this is where we go. Wait, hold on. Okay. Who are we gonna run into?
Voila! It's that disrespectful wizard Clouseau told us about. This is how I get promoted to Chief Inspector.
No! This is how I get promoted to Chief Inspector!
Nice try. No, get in there! Ah. I think I'm stuck. Oh, darn. I'm stuck. Oh, here I go. Sorry, I don't know what happened. Okay. They all fizzled. Yay! See what they got. You know, in Polaris, they have spells that are like... I don't know how... Yeah, it does that many damage, but not that bad. I think it's easy. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that some viewers said that Polaris was easy. Well, let's see how easy it gets. And while we're in Polaris, we will use like 3 rounds for a setup, if possible. And really adequate with Tempest. Oh, they don't have a... I'm speechless. Okay, Maddie with the heels, yeah. Oh, now I remember what I was gonna say. They don't have Pierce. Dark Wind, okay, that's a good advantage. Now, do I go on attack? I do. Ah, Glove of Squall. Shadow Pip chance. We have like 5%. But, not that lucky. Could be like using small attacks. That's nothing. Alright. Am I gonna get a Shadow Pip? Yes, I did. Okay. Oh. Sayonara. I ain't gonna faint, cause why not? I wanna see how much damage this will do. Oh, got that critical in. Wow, nice. Oh yeah! Oh, that must be where Klusu is hiding. Let's go.
Aha! The intruder intrudes again! And not this time am I not surprised! Wait, did I say that right? Never you mind, fiend! To arms, inspectors! The intruder is at the top of our game! None can know that the brigade is up to this fishy business.
What, am I just gonna get pulled in? Go! Okay. Don't need storm miles that much. Looks like another round we defeat Clouseau again. Whoa. No kidding. Should've packed some potions, but... never mind. At least Darkwind will be an advantage. What was that? Let's see. They're just... wow. he's got. E-fret. Wow. At least that's on me. A little bit of pierce, but it's not that bad. I'm not really attacking. As you all know, I just heal. And wait. Quaint. Let's see. Well, I'm gonna Tempest, cause why not? I'll put another Feign on.
Yeah.
Okay. What's this? I got a bad feeling about this. Fire from above, of course. That's the first time a boss ever used a Shadowhand spell. Those bosses are supposed to use them in Darkmoor, but now it's in Wildsnap. Oh! That damage, though. Oof, I gotta heal. Oh, here goes nothing. At least that Dark Wind will be an advantage. Yes! Bye-bye, minions. Sayonara. Or not. Oh, nice. Still finished him. Oh, it's so hilarious.
There is a time to laugh and a time not to laugh. And this is not one of them. I'm even outdone in my own words.
Tell that to the judge. Actually, not good with words.
The harbor master's report lists all the shipments being delivered to the Walrusburg Harbor.
Okay.
A ship called the Sea Chicken is listed as arriving with several imported tuna crates.
The Sea Chicken? Strange. Getting back, I'll get back to you. Easy. Let's hear what she has to say.
Good work. Now comes the fun part.
Ooh, fun part.
The Sea Chicken, eh? Key stance. Despicable profiteers conspire with the Empress, forcing us to buy their gross fish. Time for a poisson party. We board the ship, fight our way into the hold, and then find a way to get the imported tuna crates up onto the deck. Then, voila, we dump the crates into the harbor. It's going to be fun. Go now, I'll meet you on board the ship.
Hey, where's she going? Oh, she's going to meet us at the ship. Well, that's going to end us for today. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed, hit that like button down below. It's always appreciated. Stay tuned for more episodes, and our journey through Polaris continues. So enjoy the rest of your day, and I'll see you all next time. Bye.